Oh no! Oh, so many choices. Emotiv Epoch, BrainLink Lite, Emotiv Insight, MindWave Mobile. Last but not least, the Muse Headband. It's Dr. Cody Rall with Techforpsych. It's a question I get all the time in YouTube comments, emails, social media. And the question is, what personal EEG device should you purchase? It depends on a couple of factors, but real quick before we jump into the content, I just want to remind you guys that if you want to work one-on-one with me, there is a coaching option. Just go to www.techforpsych.com/coaching. Because of high traffic volume, I'm only looking for really motivated individuals that are a good fit. So fill out the questionnaire and I'll do my best to get back to everybody that applies.
If you like this type of information and want to learn more and you haven't subscribed yet, hit that subscribe button and click that bell so you get notifications when I upload new videos. All right, let's roll into the content and see what I found out.
So I'm gonna start this video in just cutting one of the devices out immediately because I've been messaged about this one a decent amount. And I think the reason is because it's one of the cheaper ones that's available online. I'm sorry, Neurosky, MindWave, Mobile, but you're just sorely outclassed at this point. This is the first personal EEG device that I actually bought. And if you look at the first video that I did about these things, and I'm actually wearing it on my head. I think it was a great initial foray into the personal EEG device market. It got a lot of people excited about the idea of these wireless devices transmitting EEG data from, you know, your brain to your smartphone and that being analyzed and creating programs around that so you can interact with the brainwaves. That was just a revolutionary step forward. The problem is this came out in 2011. It's only got one sensor. There's been a lot of concern about signal to noise ratio over the years and some studies that showed that if you just put it on your hand that it was creating these voltage changes. So how can you say that that's just talking about the brain? And you know, I think that, again, just an initial good step forward, but at this point, we've had so much progress. If you guys are interested in learning more about that story, you can check out my video, History of Personal EEG Devices, that I presented to a group in Hawaii. You can check that video out. But really what's happened is our smartphones have gotten 10 times more powerful than when they first came out. Bluetooth has improved, and that has allowed us to put more channels on these devices and collect more information. And I think that from what I've heard from Muse and Emotiv is that the sensor technology has improved too. So it's improved the signal to noise ratio. So at this point, anybody that's serious about, you know, either getting into neurofeedback, brain computer interface, or research, I just don't recommend this one at this point. I think that the technology has come so far that, you know, the Neurosky MindWave Mobile is out at this point. Okay, so before I dive more into this, I want to make some blanket statements. There's tons of devices that are coming into the marketplace, probably some that I'm not even aware of. Like for instance, I just got sent BrainLink Lite and BrainLink Pro from Macrotellect is coming out soon. So I'll be doing a review on that. But my current understanding of the marketplace and the devices that I've seen the most and have the biggest communities are generally Muse and Emotiv right now. And they have Emotiv Insight, Emotiv Epoch, and Muse has its own system. And there's a couple of companies that have accessories that go with Muse as well. So those are the personal EEG devices that I'm gonna focus in on. One of the things that I like about Muse and Emotiv is that they've been around long enough and have had enough of a following for third-party institutions to validate the EEG signal. And I think this is really important in this niche because people are suspicious of these devices because they're cheap, they're personalized, and there have been examples in the past where people get fooled by devices. They could be gimmicky, like the EEG signal could not be real, and it could be going off of different just skin voltage changes, you know, on the skin rather than the actual brain. So I think that these third-party institutions that validated the EEG signal through ERP studies, which are event-related potential studies, is really important. I've got a video coming out on that pretty soon, but you know, definitely Muse and Emotiv have made it a point on their website to demonstrate that compared to medical-grade devices, when you can compare their ERP signals, they're quite similar. So it's really reassuring that they're actually getting good EEG signal in their products. So the first question you should be asking yourself when you're looking to buy a personal EEG device is, what are you going to use it for? Okay. In my mind, there's three main categories right now. The first category is therapy. So either you are engaging in a meditative practice or doing some kind of attention training. The second area is brain-computer interface, where perhaps you are trying to control either a cursor on a computer screen or some kind of robotic arm or a car or something like that. The third area is research. So are you a neuroscience researcher that's taking a look at EEG in different situations and trying to understand the brain better through that? Subcategories of research could include cognitive processing that has to do with quick mental acuity and has a lot to do with gamma brain waves. Second area would be neuromarketing research, and third area would be meditation research. Now, I realize that there's other categories that could go into those other categories, but those are the areas that I see the personal EEG devices being used most at the current moment. The first category that I talked about in terms of therapy, whether that be meditation or attention training, usually through neural feedback is the main thing that personal EEG devices are going to be used for in that niche. I think it's pretty straightforward. I think that Muse is the best choice. It's the most comfortable one. They have really devoted all their resources to that niche, that meditation niche. There's different companies springing up around the world like Mindlift that are adding accessories onto the Muse headset in order to, you know, target attention even better. And their sales and professional interface team is amazing. They have amazing software, amazing community support, and a Muse Professionals program that you can join if you're interested, where you get webinars on how to use the device, either with yourself or with patients. And there's even a software development kit where if you want to make your own meditation programs or create your own software using the Muse, you can do that. So my hat's off to Interaxon / Muse Headband. They've done an amazing job in the niche, and I think that they've really taken ownership of the neurofeedback aspect of personal EEG devices, especially when it comes to meditation. I myself am doing research with the Muse. It's one that I'm the most familiar with, and I think that it's just a great product and an incredible platform. And if you are looking at either engaging in meditation or attention training or a mental health provider or a performance coach that wants to work with clients, Muse is definitely the way to go. If you're interested in using Muse therapeutically, I recommend taking a look at my videos, Muse 5 Biggest Mistakes to Avoid, 3 Tips to Prevent Boredom While Meditating, the Muse Connect video, and then my interview with Michael DeCare, who has a very successful practice in Canada using the Muse with his patients. One caveat that I want to put in here is that any one of these devices that is getting good EEG signal technically could be successful in any one of these categories. There's quite a bit of overlap. However, the companies have devoted their resources into different niches, and people, the consumer, should be aware of that before you make a purchase. You know, you wouldn't want a device that wasn't optimized for meditation if you really wanted to do meditation research, or you wouldn't want a device that's optimized for neuromarketing if that's what you wanted to do with your time. So the second category, brain-computer interface, I think it's so awesome that someone can control like a little robotic car with their mind using one of these devices, but it does take some programming skills and time. And since I'm a physician, it's hard for me to find the time to get into projects like that. I am working with a group that's forming up at DePaul University for something like that. But in the meantime, from what I can see, you definitely want more sensors, as many sensors as you can, to actually have a successful project when it comes to brain-computer interface. And since Emotiv's been around for a little bit longer, there seems to be more of a community, especially on GitHub, that has different projects related to Emotiv to use for brain-computer interface. So if you want to get into brain-computer interface, I recommend taking a look at Emotiv. And again, the more sensors that you have, the more successful you're going to be. And the second thing that you need to consider, besides what are you going to use these devices for, is what you're willing to spend. And Emotiv right now has 3 different products that go up the price point. And you know, the more that you pay, the more sensors you get. So the Emotiv Insight is a pretty cool device. You probably have seen it in a lot of my videos. There's definitely been projects with the Emotiv Insight for brain-computer interface. You see them, you know, all over YouTube and the internet, and I'm sure there's a good community to tap into to learn how to do that. Emotiv Insight going for $300. Definitely the Emotiv Epoch's been around for some time as well, and a lot of projects have been done with it, but again, going up in price for $800. They just put out a new system,
EEG system that's a lot more flexible, that goes in a cap and has quite a few more sensors. It's called the Epoch Flex Kit, and it goes for $2,100, and you can have up to 32 sensors in there. So Emotiv continuing to be a trendsetter, really listening to their audience and getting into the nitty gritty of neuromarketing and neuroscience research. Really enjoy following their president, Oliver Ollier, on social media. So if you're interested in getting into that part of the niche of personal EEG devices, I recommend taking a look at Emotiv. One thing that I should mention is that neurofeedback is a type of brain-computer interface. So if you want to do some kind of meditation virtual reality interaction as for brain-computer interface, I think Muse is the way to go. Anything that has to do with meditation, probably go with Muse, and that could have some brain-computer interface interactions as well. As far as neuromarketing goes, I put out a couple of those videos recently, and I noticed that the new Emotiv app, My Emotiv, is really set up for neuromarketing stuff. And they've really concentrated on that niche as well. And it's a very nascent, blossoming niche that is probably full of pitfalls, to be honest. So I think that people might abuse the EEG technology to make predictions or, you know, talk about things that might not be scientifically valid. But neuromarketing is coming. It's something that is going to happen. And Emotiv is really sticking their necks out, I think, to make it something that's more mainstream. So if you're really interested in neuromarketing, you should definitely check out what Emotiv has going on in that niche as well. So we're coming up on our third category, brainwave research, neuroscience research. If you want to do research that has to do with fine-tuned cognition, like one of my friends is doing research with aha moments. So the second that someone figures out the solution to a math problem or something, there's supposed to be this gamma wave burst. Stuff like that, you really need a lot of sensors. And you know, this is where I think personal EEG devices kind of push up against the boundaries of what they're capable of, because you know, people might invest in something like OpenBCI or these other platforms that allow for more sensors. And I think that it's great that Emotiv came out with this Flex Kit, because I think that people were looking for something like that in order to use this personal EEG device way of doing things, but at the same time be able to do more hardcore neuroscience research. So my friend that's doing the gamma wave aha moment stuff is using Emotiv Epoch, and she's pretty happy with it. Now, like I said, Emotiv seems to be pushing forward. The Emotiv Insight is sort of a cool, low-cost platform to start taking a look at neuromarketing stuff. The My Emotiv app seems to be optimized for it. So take a look at my neuromarketing video. I explore that topic in there. Also, my videos about Emotiv Insight include 7 things you should know before purchasing Emotiv Insight, the connectivity troubleshooting, and then the Inside Emotiv Insight videos, I think are pretty interesting if you're interested in that platform. If you want to take a look at raw data off of the Muse headband, I've got a couple of videos, mapping your brain with Muse, videos 1 and 2. So you can take a look at what that might look like if you want to get into the hardcore, you know, extracting the data through Muse Lab, putting it in the MATLAB, and using EEG Lab from UCSD to take a look at the data and potentially even do some 3D mapping. Now, that video was done almost 2 years ago now, so I think that those methods are quickly being outpaced by more seamless things that you can use, like Muse Direct, but it's worth taking a look at. One thing that I should mention is that, for example, if you're doing neuromarketing research with Emotiv Insight, the app is optimized to give you certain measures of like attention, concentration, and other emotional cues for your neuromarketing research. But in order to get the raw EEG, you need to buy the Emotiv Pro package. And it's kind of expensive. If you buy it for month to month, it's $100 a month. If you get like a 5-year package, it's like $55 a month. But, you know, I think that if you have a research institution, it's worth it as an individual consumer. I don't know, maybe you really want to get into it and Emotiv is the company for you and you want to pay that much. But Muse, you can get the raw EEG data for free. So definitely if you're doing some kind of meditation research, you know, I would go with the Muse just because you can get that data for free, and Muse is so optimized for meditation that I think that that's what you should do for that niche. The Muse headband also has a very competitive price point. It's $180. Compared to the Emotiv Insight $300 and then the Emotiv Epoch $800. So thanks for listening. Hopefully this answered some of your guys' questions about what headset to get. Again, it relies on a couple of factors.
What are you using it for and how much money do you want to spend? At the end of the day, it's just going to have to be your decision. And like I said, there's new products coming out all the time, so it's kind of hard to pigeonhole each one into a specific niche, especially if they have good EEG signal. Like I said, that there's overlap, but hopefully, again, that this was a overall guide for helping with your purchasing decisions. My name's Cody Rall. This is Techforpsych. If you guys are interested in things like one-on-one coaching, be sure to check out www.techforpsych.com/coaching. Be sure to check out the Facebook page and subscribe. So thanks so much for the listen. Signing off.